Aloha, Scott Thompson here. I'm up country Kula on the island of Maui. I want to introduce this to you. This is a Vedantic story. Swami T does a better job than me. Think of me as more somebody that's entertaining you, that's amazed by this stuff, and I want to share it with you. So these 10 boys, I'll make it very simple and quick, but these 10 boys were raised by a guru. And they were not taught academically like you and I. They were taught different ways. They were very hard workers, and there was a festivity that was going on 2 days away, and the guru was too old for this trip. So he gathered the boys and said, hey, come here. I want you guys to go to this festivity and stick together, take care of each other, and come back, okay? But go over there, have a good time. You guys have been working really hard. So the boys, being boys, they go through the jungle and all these different things, get through mischievous, and they come across this river that was just fast and deep. So they had to cross. So after a long debate, they go ahead and cross. And as they're crossing, the first one gets across. You know, he helps out the other, and he helps out the other. And all these boys are helping out each other, remembering the guru's lesson of, you know, take care of each other. One of the boys thinks to himself, you know, I'm gonna count. So he counts. He's trying to figure out who is, where's everybody at. So he counts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The other boys see that they're of 10, yeah? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And as I'm doing this, you probably see the error. They're not counting themselves, yeah? So they go and search high and low. So these boys go and search high and low. They're in the river, up the river, down the river, looking everywhere aimlessly in their ignorance, suffering, suffering, suffering. So at the end of the day, they're exhausted and they're on the side crying. Luckily, this passerby that knew Vedantic saw the boys and he's like, hey, he sees their suffering and he wants to help them. So he talks to the boys and says, what's going on? So the boys explain this long story that they were 10, now they're 9. And as soon as they say that, this passerby does a mental count and he sees 10. So he tells them first the what, the first lesson. He tells them, well, you guys are 10. That you're looking for is already with you. So the boys hear that and they're still suffering, and some of them comprehend, some of them don't. Some of them think that this is that their friend that has passed away is with them, it's this spirit, but it doesn't help their suffering. He sees that. So this Vedantic passerby knows, yeah, he knows Vedanta, so he knows the what didn't work. So he's okay. So he's going to go from the what to the how. Okay. So the how is a higher intelligence to strive for. And you'll find that the how is, there's a lot of knowledge, a lot of ways that you can rethink about things. So a little example is this passerby thinks to himself, okay, how can I get these boys to see that they're 10? So he thinks to himself, okay, show me how you came up with 9. So the boy confidently says, okay, I can do that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right there, he sees it. So he takes his hand, the passerby takes the little boy's hands and brings it to his face, and he asks the boy, who is this boy? And right there, the boy understood. He started crying. He was so happy. And 9 other boys all at the same time became enlightened. This story is a beautiful metaphor of many different things that you can teach somebody many different ways. If you can't teach them the what, you can show them the how, which is a higher form of intelligence. So I hope this may give you pause, that maybe you could put yourself in somebody's shoes, especially with your children, and see how they're thinking. Ask them, how do you come up with this? How is this? You can use a how, and you can sit down, you can take some time, and you can talk. You can slow it down and see what's going on. So if the what's not working, try use the how. Understand what's going on. Understand how that person is interpreting. Understand how that person has learned in life that they may not have been taught and been blessed by what you know. But maybe you can learn a way to show other people how they can learn what you're trying to show them. Aloha.